Hello, my name's Craig Earl, market analyst at Alpari UK, and welcome to our daily market update. Today we've got stock markets all trading slightly higher. We've had the better than expected services PMIs out of China and the Eurozone and the UK. Looking more specifically at the Eurozone, this figure came out at 48.6, which is much closer to that 50 mark, which separates growth from contraction. So it's a big improvement here, which is continuing this better data we've seen out of the Eurozone so far this year. The German figure came out higher than 55, which again is a very positive sign for the German economy, suggests that the contraction in the fourth quarter was a one-off and there's no real risk of recession in the first quarter of this year. And then the other one to note was the Spanish figure. Now this came out much closer to that, much higher again than we did get in December, and again suggests that we are starting to see the Spanish economy turn a corner. One concerning point though was the French figure. Now this came out at 43.6 as expected. However, what this does now show is that the French economy, the French services sector is actually contracting at a faster rate than both Spain and Italy. Now, given the fact that Spain and Italy were the main problems in the Eurozone last year, this would suggest again, along with the other data we've sent out of France so far this year, that maybe this could be the problem child this year. We know we've spoken previously about how they've been very slow to implement the reforms and austerity and very reluctant to do so, which means that what we could now be seeing is that the fact that the French economy is starting to become less competitive. Sticking with the Eurozone, we had these stories over the weekend out of Spain and Italy, and these are still continuing to have a bit of a negative impact on the markets. Starting in Italy, we had the news over the weekend, the polls over the weekend, which showed Silvio Berlusconi's PDL party are starting to gain on the Democratic Party, who were only a few weeks ago were significantly in the lead. And while we still don't expect them to win this election, it would suggest that they are going to gain more seats in Parliament, which means they could be much more disruptive. We know that the Democratic Party want to continue Mario Monti's programme of austerity and reforms, so they will need to pass certain things through Parliament. And if Berlusconi's PDL party do gain more seats, this means they could be very disruptive in getting these passed. The other story over the weekend in relation to the Eurozone came out of Spain. Now we've seen these corruption allegations against members of the Spanish Parliament, including the current Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy, and while at this moment in time they have been rejected, it doesn't mean over the next few months we could actually see more stories come out in relation to this, which can create further political instability here. It could lead to the resignation of Mariano Rajoy, which people are already starting to call for, which again could lead to another election. So this is again further political instability in two of the countries which were the main cause of the lack of sentiment towards the Eurozone last year. So hopefully we won't see these take off, but these are things which we are going to have to watch over the next couple of weeks. Finally, we're going to take a look at the UK data. Now, so far this morning, we've had a couple of positive pieces of data throughout the UK, starting with the January retail sales figure. Now, this showed a year-on-year increase of 1.9%. We were expecting, actually, a small drop of 0.5%. And then this was followed by the services PMI, which came out at 51.5, despite expectations of a reading a contraction figure of 49.5. Now, again, this is very positive for the UK. We did see that contraction in the fourth quarter last year, which has led to a lot of speculation that we could see the first ever triple dip recession in the first quarter this year. And what this data suggests, along with other things, especially considering the fact that the UK GDP is made up of around 70% is made up by consumer spending, this suggests that maybe the economy isn't quite as bad as we first feared, and this does lower the chances now that we are going to see that triple dip recession in the first quarter of this year. But I think we are now going to see a lot more focus paid to this Bank of England meeting on Thursday, given the fact that people are looking to the MPC members to try and stimulate the economy with further asset purchases. Now, this data isn't going to encourage them really. What we're probably going to see now is them opt against asset purchases and again wait for another month to see how the data plays out. Finally, we're going to take a look at the cable charts, and you can see that over the last couple of days we have seen the pair trading higher after finding support once again around 157, where the ascending trend line dating back to January 2009 crosses with the 61.8 fib level. And now that we have seen it test that level on two occasions, you can see that we're actually starting to see a double bottom form. So if we do see it continue to trade higher over the next couple of days and break above that neckline around 158.50, this would suggest, based on the size of that double bottom, we will see the pair move higher back towards that 160 level. For more news and analysis, check out the Alpari newsroom, which can be found at www.alpari.co.uk/newsroom. And you can also follow us on Twitter. My username is Craig_AlpariUK. And there's also the Alpari Twitter feed, that's Alpari UK Forex. Thank you very much for listening. My name is Craig Earle, a market analyst at Alpari UK.